Hey everyone, it's Rebecca with LincolnLewisCounty.com, and on today's episode of Hear All About It, we have Hallie Hill, who is a FFA alumni and now a current member of the Booster Club. Yep. You're here to talk about an actual fundraiser, but before we get into the details of that, although this is very much an agricultural area, I thought it would be a good idea to maybe just go over exactly what FFA is, what it does, that kind of thing. Okay. So, were you in FFA all 4 years of high school?
No, I believe I joined up my sophomore year, and then I served as a variety of offices as I went up through. And then a couple years ago when I moved back to the area, I joined up our Alumni Booster Club group, which is a group with parents, alumni, teachers, and then other people just supporting the FFA.
And helping to come up with fundraisers and that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. Now, what drew you to FFA? Were you raised on a farm? Did you want a career in agriculture?
I'm not exactly sure how I joined up. I had a few friends that did it, and they kind of drew me in. They always seemed like they were having a lot of fun on their mm-hmm. trips and the different projects that they would do. And I did not grow up on a farm. I was that weird kid that always wanted to grow up on a farm. Yeah. I had a lot of friends that did live on farms, and I think we owned ducks when I was younger, so that was about the extent of my SAE when I was in FFA. But
right, so that's actually probably a good point to make for any kids that are out there that would want to join FFA. It's not a requirement to be a farm kid or
correct.
Want to pursue that as an actual career.
Yes.
It's just kind of another one of those fun activities that, and you probably got exposed to more than you expected.
Yeah, you do not have to live on a farm to be an FFA, and you don't have to work on a farm or want to work on a farm when you grow up. You just need to have a passion for agriculture and bettering yourself, and it's not just agriculture. There's a lot of different groups and contests and stuff that you can do within the FFA. I remember I did a job interview competition when I was in school, and it actually drastically helped me when I went to apply for jobs the following summer because I had the skills to pull from that competition.
Right.
So that was very helpful and beneficial to me, and it had nothing to do with agriculture.
Right.
So there's a lot of good aspects within it
right.
that you can focus on if you're not interested in farming.
Right. So in addition to fundraising, what are the requirements or things that a member of FFA would be expected to do or be a part of?
I believe that you have to take a certain amount of agricultural classes per year, but again, that might just be part of the curriculum.
Mm-hmm.
And you, depending on how involved you want to be, there's different competitions, there's different things that you go to as far as state convention, national convention. There's winter weekend, which is more of just like a fun weekend to get to know other FFA members. But as far as requirements, it kind of differs for
right.
the program.
Okay, and it's probably as little or as much as a kid would want to be involved.
Mm-hmm.
They could take it as far as they, you know,
yeah.
wanted, basically. So this current raffle that you have coming up, it is a raffle for either a quarter of a processed beef
mm-hmm.
Or $400 in cash, which is a pretty good prize.
Yes.
And explain who donated the beef.
So our quarter beef is donated by Tyler Ebersole. He was a past FFA member, now alumni member.
Mm-hmm.
He owns Ebersole Custom Cutting in Adams.
Mm-hmm.
And he donated or offered to donate the quarter beef when the winner is drawn. People can choose how they want it cut, I believe.
Okay.
So we'll draw a little while before he's going to cut so he knows what they want.
Right.
And if the first place winner doesn't choose the quarter beef, then it's also a $400 cash prize. And then we have a second prize, which is $250, and that was donated by Logan's Equipment. And they also have had past FFA members that work there.
Okay.
And then our third place prize will be a $100 basket. It's going to be filled with local things from the area, gift cards, cheese, all that type
all
of stuff.
All the goodies that
yeah.
you get from Lewis County.
Yep.
So what is the cost of the raffle tickets, and where can people get them?
They are $2 a piece or 3 for $5. And anybody on the board or the Booster Club is going to have tickets with them. You can get them at school through Mr. Phelps, and there's a few other teachers that might be able to have them as well.
Okay.
So we'll put out on our Facebook like where people can find that information.
Okay. And
where they can get those.
And when is the drawing for this?
It is going to be November 9th.
November
9th.
Okay.
Meeting.
And will you announce the winner on the Facebook page?
Yep, or? We'll put it out on Facebook.
Okay.
And we'll have the person's phone number as well, so we'll be able to contact them that way.
Okay. And one other thing I wanted to go over, these fundraisers that you do, because this is just one of many that you guys do throughout the year, what do those funds go towards?
They go towards a variety of things. It might be purchasing t-shirts for the kids in the FFA group. Everything that we do benefits the students in the current FFA classes and FFA club. And it might cover parts of their trips, whether it's national or state convention. We'll donate money to each kid going, or if there's other projects or things that they need to do. We put in for a grant. It was either last year or the following year, and we were able to purchase hydroponics, which is now used by the high school FFA classes, and they get to work with the elementary students and show them how to work those. So there's a lot of different ways that it benefits the students.
So yeah, these fundraisers really, there's a lot of needs that are, or gaps within the program that these fundraisers help fill. So this is your most recent fundraiser.
Yep.
The next thing's coming up, you said possibly a chicken barbecue.
Yes.
But the details are still being hammered out for that.
Yep. We're hoping to do a chicken barbecue on a Saturday in October. Mm-hmm. We are working with the guy that helps us cook the chicken to see when it was available, when he was available. So when we get better details on that, we'll put it on our Facebook page
Excellent. So details for that are on Facebook. Details will be on Facebook. Details for this beef raffle will be on the Facebook page. And basically anyone that's looking to buy a ticket, go to the Facebook page, go to Mr. Phelps, go to probably any teacher at Lovell, really, or student.
Yep, they can put you in contact.
Yeah, okay. Great. Well, we really appreciate you coming in, Haley, and I'm sure this will be a very successful fundraiser for you guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.